Hi, I'm Eric Wilkinson, and I'm one of the therapists in UK's Office of Work Life. Today, I'd like to spend a little bit of time talking about the importance of intentional action and engaging in pleasurable activities during difficult times. With COVID-19, many of us have experienced elevated anxiety and feelings of fear. This is normal when there's rapid change and uncertainty in the world, as well as elevated public health risk. What we know is that when people experience increases in anxiety, often they neglect to take care of themselves in terms of both their physical health, their emotional health, but also in terms of pursuing purposeful action consistent with their values and interests. So let's first start with just reviewing what we mean by psychological well-being. Within the literature, psychological well-being is understood as the presence of positive feelings, infrequent negative feelings, and overall life satisfaction. Another important concept relevant to our discussion is the concept of the happy life. This was developed in 2002 by Martin Seligman. The three components of the happy life are positive emotion, engagement in life, and meaning or purpose. So when we think about a difficult time when there's lots of change, there's lots of uncertainty, and our stress levels are really high, these are times when we have the tendency to withdraw, to shut down, to use a term that's out there in the public domain, to shelter in place, to kind of ride out the storm. As we know, these current changes in our society are somewhat undetermined regarding their time frame. So I think it's really important that we engage in intentional behaviors, that we engage in pleasurable activities that enhance our psychological well-being. One way to make this a priority in your life is simply to do an internet search for pleasurable activities. If you Google pleasurable activities, you'll see many different lists on the internet. I encourage you to do this and just look through some of the activities and to think about how these activities, what's their significance to you? What activities stand out? What resonate with your interests and with your value system? Also think about which of these activities are things that I can do at home and are things that could be modified to do at home. When we think about why does this matter? Well, a big part of why psychological well-being matters is it improves our resilience, our ability to experience stress and to persevere, to bounce back from stress. It helps us to adapt to new changes, to make adjustments. Most importantly, it helps us to live an authentic life, a life where it's reflective of our values, reflective of our interests. When I work with folks, I often will encourage them to do a close examination of what values are most important to them. If you stop and you take the time to really reflect on what matters to me most, for some folks, they might say it's family. For other folks, it might be knowledge. It might be their spirituality or their religion. It might be new adventures. It might be creativity. It might be compassion for others. There are many values all worthy of important attention in the world. What matters most is that you spend some time and think about what are the most important values for me and how do I put my values into practice. One of the ways that we can actualize our values is through intentional behavior. And we know through research that intentional behavior, specifically, behavioral activation can improve psychological well-being. I would like to propose six different categories of pleasurable activities or intentional behaviors for you to consider and think about how can I bring these type of pleasurable activities, make them central to my life, make them a part of my daily routine. The first category involves nature and sensory experiences. So regarding nature, this could be activities like going for a hike, sitting outside and listening to birds, One of the activities I really enjoy is when it rains, I like to get my umbrella, walk outside, listen to the rain as it hits my umbrella, smell the rain in the air, maybe feel the moisture, the mist on my face, look at the puddles when I walk, pay attention to how the rain falls off the leaves of trees, and look at the vibrant green grass in response to the rain. This mindful activity brings me great joy and satisfaction. It relaxes my nervous system, and it makes me feel grounded. In terms of sensory experiences, this could be anything from giving yourself a massage to intentionally smelling some essential oils, to enjoying a hot cup of coffee, or mindfully eating a tasty dessert. It could also be just sitting outside and feeling the sun hit you in the face. Second category of pleasurable activities are creative and artistic activities. Now, I want to separate creativity from art. Art, as most of us know, involves technique, and it can consist of activities like painting or sculpting, drawing. It could also be creative writing, poetry, literature. With creativity, what we're talking about is simply putting two elements together in a new way. So they can be different ideas. It could be visually putting two different things together in a new way. If you're cooking, it could be adding new ingredients to a meal that you prepare. One activity that I like to encourage people to do is to think of two characters or two or three characters in either a film or a novel or a TV show that you like, and imagine how they would be responding to our current pandemic. Or imagine these characters coming together and having dialogue during a dinner party. You could even write out a short story where you create a different world and your favorite characters are present and they are faced with some kind of challenge or some kind of difficulty, and you see how they respond to the challenge. Basically, the idea is bring different things, new elements together. Another way you can be creative is just to engage your imagination, to set aside time to fantasize, to daydream. The third domain of activities, pleasurable activities, involves movement or sport. We know that with movement that our body releases endorphins and other pleasurable chemicals, and it boosts our immune system, it elevates our mood. So looking for opportunities to bring movement into your daily routine is very important. You can also re-engage old sports, such as shooting baskets outside, or if you used to play soccer, getting a soccer ball, going to a green space and juggling soccer. The fourth category of pleasurable activities are intellectual activities. This could include attending a training or a lecture, professional development. It could be researching topics of interest. It could be sitting and meditating. One of the things I like to encourage people to do is to think of something that interests them and look it up on Wikipedia. Read through the posts on Wikipedia, but then also any hyperlinks that interest you, follow those hyperlinks and start to surf through Wikipedia. This can result in hours of intellectual engagement and learning. A fifth category for pleasurable activities are games, technology, and entertainment. This could be video games, it could be computer games, it could be playing cards, it could be Pictionary, it could be doing jigsaw puzzles or crossword puzzles. Technology could be looking at YouTube videos or creating YouTube videos, TikTok videos, building a website or developing a blog. And entertainment could be where we watch Netflix or we watch sports, even if they're classic sports. The sixth category is for pleasurable activities are social and spiritual activities. In terms of social, this just means reaching out and connecting to people through FaceTime, through Zoom, through writing cards, even through purposeful compassion meditations. Regarding spiritual pleasurable activities, it could be reading religious texts. It could be attending online religious services. It could be praying. It could be meditating. So again, when we think about these six different categories of pleasurable activities, nature and sensory experiences, creativity and art, movement and sport, intellectual activities, games, technology, entertainment, and social and spiritual activities. Think what stands out to you individually. What kind of activities give you meaning and purpose? One of the ways to do an assessment regarding what matters most is to think about what kind of activities do I become completely absorbed in? What activities are intrinsically meaningful or enjoyable to me, where it's not about the end result, it's just simply about engaging in the activity. In other words, what activities create a flow state where you lose track of time, where your awareness and action merges as one? Identify these activities and make it a intentionally plan to engage in these activities as part of your daily routine. We know this will enhance psychological well-being. It will also enhance your resiliency. Thank you for spending some time with me today. If you would like to schedule an appointment with me or any of the other three counselors in Work Life, just remember that our counseling services are completely free as a UK benefit for employees, dependents of employees, and retirees. Have a wonderful day, be safe, and be well.